First gear pull so you can see. Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the channel. So today we got to talk about maybe one of the most important things you can do to your Hellcat right when you get it, tires. So let's get going. All right, so when I got this car back in 2015, I had opted for, I didn't really think about it, but I think it was just the default, was the all seasons. The Pirelli P0 Niro, all seasons. Doing something like this, get on the highway, right? So we gotta do a quick little run here. So yeah, I've done this plenty of times in the P0 Niros. I'd be here about second gear, 40, and there. If I would do that, car would be sliding. So P0 Niro, you can get in the summer tire. I think it was like a few hundred dollars extra. Probably should have gone that route. But the summer tire maybe provides more grip. But I can tell you that the all-season P0 Niros were terrible. They should have called those no seasons. So down here in Florida, we have what, maybe one season, two seasons? It gets a little cool in the winter, but for the most part, it's basically just hot. And it rains. So those are the two conditions you pretty much have on the road. You have hot and dry, and you have rainy, wet, right? And we got a lot of rain though, so something down here in South Florida, the rain is no joke. But those tires were terrible. So in the dry, I'd slip out just doing something like that, second gear pull from 40 miles per hour. In the wet, forget it. I mean, even traction control couldn't really keep up with those tires. So they were pretty bad. And when it got even cooler outside, the tires were even worse at hooking up. P0 Niros had to go. So the first thing I did was, well, they're fine. I mean, you can keep them in the front. They have enough tread wear. So what I did was I kept two of the P0 Niros in the front, and I decided, look, I'm gonna go with something that really hooks and sticks. So I ended up getting the Nitto 555Rs, which is essentially like a street legal drag radio, right? Super soft compound. I knew going into it that I'd probably really only get maybe 3 to 5,000 miles. That's what those tires are rated at. But I was like, you know what? I'm so sick of not hooking up with these P0 Niros. I completely swing the other way and get a tire that hooks, but maybe doesn't last that long. And it was fine because in terms of the mileage that I was putting on the car, it really wasn't that much of an issue. So I went with the Nitto 555Rs. The first impression on those tires were, first of all, they looked incredible. So there was not much tread wear. I got them in the same size that the stock tire, 275/40. I didn't try to go with the 305s. And keep like a lower profile tire. But one thing I did notice about those Nitto 555Rs is even in the stock size, they didn't quite look the same. They looked like they were a little shorter than the stock tire. I had the stock tires in the front to compare. So Nitto 555Rs, great tire. They hooked, awesome. Problem is those tires in the rain were really sketchy. So I remember I would pretty much avoid driving that car if I knew it was gonna be raining heavily. And if I did get stuck in rain, I would pretty much just have to very, very be careful in terms of the car, how much throttle I would give it, because they just didn't have that much tread. So they were pretty slippery in the rain. So Nitto 555Rs, great tire in the dry, terrible tire in the wet. P0 Niro's terrible tire pretty much any time, the no season tires. And so then I went shopping for a tire, and it was time to find something that was livable, had a little bit more than 3 to 5,000 miles in terms of its tread wear, something that I could comfortably drive in the rain. I said, I want to be able to drive this car whenever I want to drive it. I don't want to be like white knuckle driving this car. If, you know, there's a shower out, depending on where I go. Like, I literally had to plan my drives around the weather forecast. And the weather forecast down here in Florida is notoriously unreliable. So I remember there would be days where I'd be like, oh yeah, you know, I'm not taking the car because it looks like it's gonna rain. 90% chance of rain, blue skies the whole day, right? Then there'd be other days, yep, 0% chance of rain, take the Hellcat, bam, get stuck in like a torrential downpour on the way back. So I was just kind of just sick of all that, and I decided, all right, you know what, I'm just gonna get tires that I could drive every day, and even if they don't hook as well as the Nittos, that's fine. I couldn't imagine that there was a tire as worse as the P0 Niros, all seasons. So I went looking around. First tire I looked at was the Nitto 555G2s, since I was already in the Nitto family. Those looked okay, but I talked to a buddy of mine back in the day that had those on a Mustang with you know, the stock horsepower, and it was like 450 or somewhere around that. And he said they were sliding all over the place on 555 G2s. So I decided, yeah, let's not do that. So I started looking around. You know, you can find a bunch of reviews on Tire Rack. You can find some reviews on, you know, just random sites. I think even Discount Tire Direct, you can find some stuff. And I came across the Continental Extreme Contact Sport tire. And specifically, I think it was the DW, because DWS is the one that first snow, that's all season. ZW is just dry and wet. Seemed like it had really good reviews. A lot of people were talking about it. What's nice about Tire Rack is you can actually filter by the car of the person that did the review. And there were some people there with at least scat packs that had put in reviews. I think there might have been even someone with a Hellcat there. And so, okay, high power car, similar chassis, you know, rear wheel drive. How these people like it? And it's pretty much good reviews all around. Good reviews, it hooked a lot, wet performance was really good. So I decided, you know what, let me try this out. Now the tire itself cost about the same as the Nittos. So the Nittos were, I wanna say about 300 something a pop. And the Contis were around the same amount. So it wasn't a cheap tire by any means. It wasn't a super expensive tire, but it wasn't like a budget tire or something like that. Like I had, when I was getting ready to sell the Subaru STI, I was looking, okay, I had to get tires because the tires were just cracked, like dangerously cracked. I wasn't gonna sell a car in that condition. So I was looking around for tires, but I also didn't necessarily want to be putting on like $400 tires on a car that I'm about to sell. So my tire guy, he recommended Mucho Macho Cosmo tires. And I was like, what is this? This is the funniest name. I've never heard of this tire, Mucho Macho. But I said, you know what? That's fine. He said they're good. They seem to get good reviews online. I went with the Mucho Macho tires. I tell you what, they were pretty good. That car, obviously, a little bit less concerned because it's all-wheel drive, right? So I got four tires that are doing their work with the symmetric all-wheel drive system. Don't really need to be too worried, you know, one tire is slipping or whatever, something else will grab. And they did a good job with that. But for this tire, when I was looking around, I was, yeah, looking at these tires, and the Continental Extreme Sport Contact tires seemed like a good fit, so I decided to pull the trigger on these tires. Let me tell you something. These tires, I feel, have been amazing. So, been on them for a while now. The tread wear, there still seems to be enough left. On a side note, the Nittos, so this is like a PSA, make sure you check your tread wear on your tires. I mean, you know, just keep an eye on them every now and then. With the Nittos, I guess because I just kind of got blindsided by how short they lasted, I didn't do that. And here, let's do a little pull here real quick. See, there, just these tires, Conti, hook and go. No slip, right? Now, the Nittos, though, what happened was, I remember I was coming out of the grocery store one time. I'm looking at the car, I'm like, what is it? Actually, I don't know if it was me. It might have been my son that noticed. He was like, hey, you got like garbage on your tire or something. What is that on the bottom? And I was like, yeah, that's right. It's like I got like a label or something stuck to it. I went closer to inspect it. It was the steel belts of the tires. That's super dangerous. So yeah, PSA guys, is just keep an eye on your tire. You don't want to let it go that bad. That could have been really bad, right? Especially a car like this, that this much horsepower. I could have done a pull or something like that and just blown the whole tire out, and that would have been, you know, that would have been terrible. So anyways, that was my mistake. Learned from that. So the Continentals, tread's been lasting a while. It's been pretty good. It hooks like you just saw that right there, and it just goes. And in the rain, I feel super confident. I've driven this car, you know, through torrential downpours like we have down here in the summer. And I really haven't noticed the degradation of performance. I feel like it's a really good all-around tire for down here. Now, if you need to drive something in the snow, I'm sorry, I can't really comment on that. Maybe the DWS, that from the same Continental Extreme Contact Sport, the DWS might be your tire. Probably what you're gonna do, though, realistically, is if you do drive this car in the winter and you live in somewhere that has a bunch of snow, it's probably going to be, you're going to be probably be better off at that point just having a set of winter snow tires, right, that you can put on the car instead of trying to use the same tire all year round. I think it's asking too much from a tire to be able to do everything, to be able to really good hook, in the summer, in the wet, and also be able to manage the snow when the snow hits. Then you got to daily that car around. So probably look at two sets of tires. That way also you keep a different set of rims, winter rims that you don't really care about that much, you know. I mean, you probably can't fit Steelys on this car because of the brakes, but you can probably find something that's kind of cheap, like a cheap cast wheel that you just, you know, put some winter tires on and call it a day. If you're looking for a tire recommendation, really recommend you look at the Continental Extreme Sport Contacts. You know, you're asking a lot from a tire on this car, right? At the end of the day, this is a 700 horsepower car, 650 pound-feet of torque. That's a lot for any tire to handle, and it's rear wheel drive, right? So the rear tires have to do all the work. So yeah, it's a lot to ask, but I feel like this tire fits that balance. Okay, look, we'll do a first gear pull so you can see. See that? Yeah, there was some slippage at first, but 700 horsepower car. And yes, I bounced off the rev limiter, if anyone caught that. But after shifting in the second, got a little bit of squeal, but not much. With the P0 no seasons, I'm sliding all over the place doing a move like that. I'd have scared that Mercedes owner. Poor dude just going out for some sushi in the morning. So anyways, love to hear from you guys about tires that you run, how they work out. Hope you got something out of this. Check out these next videos, and I'll see you there. Thanks. Bye.